on, too.
Yes, sir.
Well, it seems like it's on, Kevin.
No doubt about it, brother. We got to get them Led Zeppelin lights turned up now, buddy. Look at that. You haven't got around. I got my pill bottle full of picks. Tis. Tis, 1-2. Haven't got it. Have you listened to this? Hold on, no, listen. How good is it? $300. Yeah. We're after performing all around the country since we've been here last fall, man. Talk about good. You hear something leaking?
I do, boy. Yes.
Boy jumps. Oh, no, his buddy rattling a plastic bag eating chips now. That's all right, Cock. Don't you stop eating your chips now, because we're playing jokes or nothing like that.
Fine crowd, Kevin, we got here.
Yes, boy, yeah. I hope they stay. Drive him a tune on that. Now we'll see what we can do. Come in late, yeah.
They had to stay behind and do their homework, don't they?
Oh, yes, I'm sure. Just march right in, yeah, sit down.
The only can get away that in Corner Brook, that right?
You're bloody right. Well, hey, old man, where are you from?
Me?
Yes, I know where you're from. I just want the crowd to know where you're from, you know.
Well, does anyone know where the Avalon Peninsula is?
No, not at all.
Ready to tell you the truth, old man. We've been trying desperately hard to cut off the eastern section of that for years.
That's right. Well, I'm from a place called Job's Cove.
Job's Cove.
And there's about 203 people. Real count yesterday, Kevin. 203 people, yeah.
203.
And I must say, it's not very hard to say hello in the run of a day.
Two of them all, you mean? Every one of them.
Yeah.
Not too hard. No, I don't say it is too hard.
Don't even have to take the hands off the wheel.
No, but I just give him a wink and a nod. No, I dare not. If you give him a wink, you won't miss him.
Yes.
Passing through there. Yeah. Where are you from? This is Wayne Jock. Where are you from, Wayne?
Yeah. I'm from Charlottetown, Bonavista Bay, Terranova National Park, home of the plywood moose. Yeah. Dirty big ones.
Plywood moose, aren't they?
They're plywood.
Now, Kevin, don't tell me you did something foolish.
I emptied a whole magazine in one of them last year before he finally dropped.
No.
I told you you shouldn't have done that, you know.
Kind of hard to butcher too, boy. I had to use a chainsaw.
Tough, were they?
Tough, my sonny boy. Dogs laughed at me when I brought it home. They're only this thick, so you're going to only get so much steak out of them, you know?
Yes, yeah.
How many people up in Charlottetown?
324.
324 people in Charlottetown? Mm-hmm.
326, actually. Bonnie's got twins.
Go on, Bonnie, you don't mean... Bonnie just had twins?
Ralph's Bonnie.
Ralph's Bonnie just had twins? Mm-hmm. Bet your Ralph's on the lookout for the other feller.
Probably. Hey, Kevin, where are you from?
Glovertown. Greater metropolitan, right, yeah. Glovertown.
Yes.
The surrounding area, of course, is a population of 2,300 people.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to rope in the boroughs of Culls Harbour, Trade Town, Glovertown South, Glovertown Central, Glovertown North, Saunders Cove, and Shag Rock. And we're talking thriving metropolis,
yes.
Johnson.
Yeah. But just getting back to Charlottetown, I don't know if you're aware of this, Wayne, but there are two Charlottetowns.
Oh, yes, Ray, yeah, there's two. There's one in Labrador besides the one I'm from.
Yeah.
Oh, isn't that right? Yeah. Watch out now, look at that, eh? Somebody else robbing that name, no?
Oh, yes, I'm sure.
Yeah. You watch out now, there'll be some other crowd pretty soon robbing that name. Charlottetown, yeah?
Yeah.
I can just hear it now, Charlottetown PEI, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, it's got a ring to it, hasn't it?
It's got a ring to it, I suppose, yeah.
Guaranteed.
Now, your father is from Glovertown too, isn't he?
Yes, yeah. No, father old man. Yeah.
I just heard the other day he was an awful man to curse.
No, he wasn't an awful man to curse. No, he was not an awful man to curse. He was good at it.
Good at it? I see.
Hi.
She's only getting the laugh now, Kevin, look.
Good thing they put out the extra chairs, eh, boy? You'd have nowhere to sit if you came in, there was nothing there. Oh, no doubt you had to look at it before you come down. Yes, boy, half a man's where you Father would let go a line. By the time he let it out, see it bounce off the far wall, he'd have another one out.
I see.
And by the time that one's travelling back at him, the two would meet in mid-air and start to scorch and burn when they collided.
Right.
He couldn't swear, could he? Peel the paint off a wall from 50 yards, old man.
Powerful stuff, eh?
Powerful stuff. You got a fiddle. Just play along with this. Father fished 5 days a week. He went to church on Sunday, confessed his sins, and then he'd begin to sin again on Monday. Don't get me wrong, he never sinned, indeed no worse than sin in word, but you should have heard the way that man could curse. He went bird lippin' meetin' lion Gary, and the dance for dying, flopping, thundering, working, wondering, robbing, gobbling, hurry. Hell for a fine flame on the streets and dreaming, naming, believing, son of an old good murdering murder is young Joseph Murphy. One day father fished his last, it happened this way. He snagged his finger on a hook and the boat began to sway. We fell into the water, but he never should have drowned. But he couldn't keep his mouth shut the third time he went down. He went, Lord, let me be lying there, reeling, dancing, dying, suffering, thundering, working, wandering, robbing, gobbling, hurry. Hell's fiery flame, flaming the streets and screaming, naming, blaming, son of an old God, murder, a mother, a jewel, you don't want to murder. Some say he's down below, but I don't believe that's true. I dare allow he's in heaven above, turning the air bright blue. 'Cause I remember, Father, the happiest time that he ever was. Cursing till he was blue in the face, or yet time for nothing else. He'd go live. Don't catch them by their fast movers. They multiply fast. Oh, yeah. Had to have the drink before you come to the show, hey?
Kevin, drink. I'm just wondering if we're a bit too loud for the people. Are we too loud for you, or?
Someone said yes.
Someone said yes. We
turn it all off. Turn it all off. Someone said yes. If we're too loud, that's because, you know, the crowd in the back can't hear too well. Probably want to play a bit of rotation, you know, I mean, you know, sort of move around a bit. Or some of you could take a turn up in front, you know. Yeah, we've been around the country recently, I must say. And we've met some wonderful people, haven't we? Oh, traveled to the mainland there last week. Anybody here from Toronto?
Yes, there's one guy, Kevin.
Go on. Who's that? You seen that?
Oh, yes, yeah. He stuck his hand up once.
Yeah.
Didn't want to try it.
You from Toronto, buddy? Yeah, he's lying.
Well, what Kevin is really trying to say is, welcome to civilization. That's what Kevin.
Johnson, not as fast, is it? We've been to Toronto.
Yes, we certainly have.
We was to Toronto. Look at it.
Well, you can't see nothing else, Kevin. Now, listen, before we get into the Toronto thing, I think it's only right to tell the people where you bought the pants and...
The wardrobe, Kevin.
The wardrobe.
Yes, explanation.
Well, I get all my clothes in exotic markets, you know, like shoes.
Yes.
Where?
Paris.
Pants?
Pants. London.
Shirt.
New York.
Really?
Yeah, the whole works. London, New York, and Paris.
How about the tie?
Well, the tie is another story, boy. The tie is another story. People give me ties, you know? All kinds of them. Want to see some more? You know the pet shop over there, down the road a ways? This one was eating a rat in there one day when I arrived. Happened to be a steamroller outside, I jutted it out and I should have seen the gut squirt across the road. This one, oh man, look at that one. Hot pink, look. Blind you when you focus the light right on it, you know. Yeah. I got another one here, oh man, look. Wicked, eh? You remember LSD? Fellow who designed that one got on the pills one night, went rig dog savage. What a trip he had, eh? Nice, anyway. You got regular Canadian politician dull drab wheat, which ain't much. You just chuck that one aside. This is one that's the girly time. Get that one on the cable, though. Ah! This is another psychedelic one. Changes colors, you switch it around, you know. Blind, you know, the kind of thing. This one is my favorite one altogether. Color TV with vertical knob gone screwy.
Yeah. But there's a little story behind your pants, though, really, isn't there?
Oh, yes, yeah.
Where'd you get them, Kevin?
Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Now, how did this come about?
Well, I walked into the store late one night, Simon, nobody around, right? Don't know what I had in my hands, I forget what I had in my hands, and I walked in toward the back. Now, the back, see, just fell in there frying chips. Only man in the store besides myself, see, and I walks in and lifts up the leaf in the counter and it creeps in and back and say, don't remember what I had in my hand at the time, but I comes up on back of him, see, and I taps him on the shoulder. And I said, hey, buddy, where'd you get the pants?
What did he say?
Get out.
So, how did you get the pants?
Oh, well, then I turned around, see, and applied for a job at Kentucky Fried Chicken.
And quit.
Now, then I got the job, and then I quit.
Yeah.
As soon as I got the pants.
But anyway, we were up in Toronto.
Oh, yes, yeah. Anybody here ever been to Toronto? You might not be from Toronto, but perhaps you've been to Toronto.
Well, I have to admit, the pace up there is much quicker than Job's Cove.
Oh, you got to admit it, old man. They got more stoplights up there.
Yes, that's right.
I noticed that because you haven't got no stoplights in Job's Cove.
No.
Nor in Charlottetown, for that matter. I don't know we got none in Glovertown.
But, Chuck Kevin, there's so many people on the sidewalks in front of them.
500,000, sir, on one sidewalk alone, I dare allow, on any good given day, you know. Mm. That's the population of Newfoundland. Yeah. Difficult to say hello to them all, you can't do it, you know. You break your neck trying, you know. Mm. You know what? Sorry. Utilizing everything at your disposal, I mean to say, one to the right, one to the left, and a full frontal. You can't do it. It is impossible. It is physically impossible to say hello to everybody in Toronto in the run of a day.
And the trouble is, you don't get any response back, except
well, you get the odd one, you know.
The occasional
one. Hey, you know, buddy, got a buck? That's my favorite one. There's more.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I've seen more, but there's that, you know. You go on, hey, you know, buddy? Oh, hi. You know the kind, don't you, Ray?
Yes, they weren't really satisfied what God gave them, were they?
No, they went and messed it up. You know. Hospital miracles, we call them, right?
Hospital miracles,
trouble at manpower, didn't they?
Oh, yes, boy. Every time a fellow like that goes into manpower, see, they ask them if they're male or female because they can't tell, and they says, put the X in the middle.
Yeah. But when we got down to the subway, it was very fast, wasn't it?
Yeah. Anybody ever seen a subway? 2,000 people can go past you in 10 seconds flat.
That's so true.
Fair something. You can't say hello to them all, see, there's no way.
But you can't get them all around.
Even if you turn her up on maximum, you know. No, it's no good. Break your neck. We had a fellow up there who was teasing us all the time because we were from Newfoundland, real live Newfoundland. Poke, poke, trying to make sense. Poke. Hey, Newfie, got any big buildings back on the island like that?
He said, just cocky, we do.
Oh, come on, not as tall as that. No, boy, because we laid them on their sides, call them shopping malls. It's all in the way you look at things, isn't it, boy? What? Horizontal thinking.
But the character come across on the boat, you know, the ferry. That's the ferry, you know.
The ferry is a boat. Yeah. In case you get the wrong idea. Yeah, there's an old man on that. Old man, he was the funniest old sort.
Oh, he was a wonderful
We was on the boat, and the old man was up on the promenade deck, spitting gobby hotters over the side. And he was timing them to see how long it was to the face of the earth. Or in this case, the water. You see? Because he was figuring out this boat, so mine must be 60 feet, you know?
That was a heavy one.
Well, you see, Raymond, it don't matter about the weight of a gobbyhocker. Now, the science of gobbyhockers is not fully known. However, we do know that if a gobbyhocker spreads out like an envelope, sort of like an amoeba on a glass slide in biology class.
Yes, yes.
He's going to sort of float to the ground instead of drop like a bucket. You know, did it.
Of course, Kevin, the color is important, too.
The color is important, yeah. Hey, you know, like, that's Rufus.
That's our old friend Rufus down there.
Did you come down for carnival, did you? Yeah. You going skiing by or what? It's all right, man. Yeah. And the color is important.
Well, he was some man to chew, though, wasn't he? Yes.
Oh, yes, yes.
Some man to chew.
What were you talking about, the color?
Yes.
The color of gobbyhockers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The gulls.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Well, if they're too brightly colored, see, the gulls picks up on them, picks them right up. Just no good. You're interested in this, aren't you? And anyway, there he was, he was pitting gobbyhockers over. And he was timing them. Oh, it might be a second and a half, old man. That's got to be about 50 feet.
Sure.
That's what he was saying, see? You're going to be 50 feet, old man. You know, because, you know, gravity will pull something toward the face of the earth at the rate of 32 feet per second squared. 10 meters per second squared, whatever you like. Have it which way you like it. Metric, same thing. A second and a half, Cameron Tito, man. Got to be 50 feet. Got to be more than 50 feet, perhaps.
Yes.
Show me buddy who was with us. Remember the fellow I was telling you about? The fellow from Toronto? He was coming along with us. He was going to come home with us for a cup of tea. And he come down so far, and then he come on. And he would say, sir, can you tell me the time? He was standing there. Sir, can you tell me the time? And the old man looked up in. No. And he went back to what he was doing. And of course, Buddy said, I see you have a watch. Why didn't you tell me the time? No man is like this. If I goes and tells you the time, well, we're going to have a chat. And we be stood up here having a coffee and overwalk the missus. Mm-hmm. And she'll want to have a chat.
Oh, no doubt.
No doubt she will. Mm-hmm. And she'll be stood up there talking to you. No doubt she'll keep you talking there until we dox and part of this. Right? Mm-hmm. And then she'll have you in for a cup of tea. And 6 months of dating goes by, and she'll come home some night and say, oh, she's going to marry you. Well, I can't have me daughter marrying anyone who haven't got a watch. Oh, well, foresight, eh?
Nice song. We should change the subject now and get Wayne into a song.
You want to do a tune?
Yes, boy.
One of his own songs, too, by the way.
Wayne's going to sing a song. Which song is this? Wayne writes a lot of songs. Which one is this?
This one's called Going Out the Bay.
Oh, Going Out the Bay, yeah. When it's hot enough, old man, to bake dog turds on the sidewalks in Toronto, they envy us down here. This is a little song about what it's like out around the bay.
Going out the bay on a sunny day to the islands for tonight. Body is as loose as a worn-out tooth, but my mind is so uptight. And a cup of tea for my bloodstream, a song to still my soul. Wouldn't trade it in for a limousine nor a mountain made of gold. Well, I just got back from the city, where there's bodies cramped in space. Right or wrong, like it or not, you feel you're in a race, where there's hands out for your money and you're always short on time. Just when you think you're out in front, you're looking up, someone's behind. So going out the bay on a sunny day to the islands for tonight. Body is as loose as a worn out tooth, but my mind is so uptight. And a cup of tea for my bloodstream, a song to still my soul. Wouldn't trade it in for a limousine nor a mountain made of gold. So with the wind all gone and the sinking sun, silence in the cove, and the smoke from the campfire rising, with the pot just simmering slow, will your troubles start to vanish and your worries fade like fog? 'Cause your heart is where it wants to be, with your bum on an old drift log. So going out the bay on a sunny day to the islands for tonight. Body is as loose as a worn out tooth, but my mind is so uptight. And the cup of tea for my bloodstream, a song to still my soul. Wouldn't trade it in for a limousine nor a mountain made of gold. Wouldn't trade it in for a limousine or a mountain made of gold.
In 1973, while I was scoting away trying to finish off that bit of, oh, I can't remember what it was, trade school or something, Raymond Johnson was over there in Halifax making a big hit. And he was wandering around from bar to bar and sort of wooing the women, and his wife don't know nothing about half of what went on.
Don't go telling lies like that.
And he was a recording artist then over, I don't know how many times. When did you start recording records anyway?
Well, really, it was in 1972.
72, didn't he go? He goes a long ways back, don't he, boy? Mm. Probably. Ray, you're getting old.
Well.
Ray, you've got six albums behind you, haven't you?
Six albums, yep. But mm-hmm. Never made no money, and still not making no money.
Well, old man, don't complain to me.
No, but I mean, the costumes you're wearing are costing you a little bit of money there now, Kevin.
Thousands.
Yes.
Get on with the song, will
you? Oh, fishermen, they dory out the coast of Newfoundland. Gold mines, but cut lines, the life that really ran. The scuff of fish and rolls, it's the life that I enjoy. Oh, fishermen, they dory in the morning. Oh, fishermen, they dory on the banks of Newfoundland. Yawning fish woman, you're acting like a man. The tide is not too strong, then the tune is not too wrong. Oh, fishermen, they dory in the morning. With your body on the curry and the fire up the shore.
Any of them words in the Newfoundland dictionary?
Yes.
No. Are they?
Well, no, I don't know for sure, Kevin.
No, boy.
No, I don't think so.
I mean, they don't sing out.
I mean, having gazed and pondered over the manuscript myself. Not an expert, mind you, but I don't think they stuck afterwards in it that they should have.
Oh, no.
You're right.
No, you take ordinary words, right. S-W-I-T, swit.
No, not in the dictionary.
Not to be found, Kevin.
Not in the dictionary, is it, boy?
No,
what?
Not
in the dictionary.
To be found. No.
Arse farts.
That's right.
Arse farts.
That's a new one, isn't it?
That's not new, old man. That goes way back.
It's a new one for the dictionary, yes.
Well, it'd be new for the dictionary if it was in there. No. Arse farts. H-O-R-S-E-F-A-R-T-S. Arse farts. There are little puff balls on the ground. You step them and they go... Poof. That's arse farts. Perhaps you call them that, perhaps you don't. Ordinary everyday words they don't put in the dictionary. I don't. S-K-A-L, skull.
Oh, skull, yes.
What water does to a finger? You stick it in there, it's bound. B-Y-O-N, bound. Skull. P-Y-Z-I-N, poison. Don't eat that poison. That's arse farts, that's poison. A-V-E, A. I've got over to work, that's arse farts, that's poison. T-D-I-T. Tidit. You can be scalded it. You could be burned it. I suppose you could work today. Providing you don't work for the government.
And then is the darts, isn't it?
The D-D-A-R-T-S, run on, the darts. Mm. Where are you in Newfoundland if you don't know what the darts are? The darts, the 501, the ton, run on. Mm.
But of
the
course,
old bingo. Yeah. Run on,
but of course, that's not to be confused with the darts.
And D-A-R-T-S, the darts, and D-A-R-T-S, darts, not the same thing. That's Darts and Culture Centre, that's what you're talking about.
Then, of course, that famous one, Pepsi, is it, Kevin?
P-I-P-S-A-E, Pipsy. You've seen it before, haven't you? Pipsy. Pipsy free. Yeah?
But it's not free, is it? No,
no, it's not free, but no. I spent a dollar on trying to get a can out of a machine there this afternoon, and it's not free, I'll tell you. Ha! Yeah.
Then, of course, is the gas and oil situation.
G-A-Z-E-N oil, gas and oil. You mentioned gas and oil out in St. John's. Everybody goes to Willie and tries to rent up $100 a month. That's a great laugh, old man. Don't do that out in the woods in moose season. You'll be shot. You hear that, Ray? In rut.
Oh, that's a good laugh.
That's it. We got a song called Gas and Oil. G-A-Z-N oil.
As soon as we gets the gas and oil, know how we share about. As soon as we gets the gas and oil, know how we share about. Two cars in every garage, the big cigar for every dad. TV dinner on the stove, all me nerves, you got me droll. How we share about? How we share about? Freddy's always on the front porch, copacetic. Freddy's always on the front porch, copacetic. Well, his kids will never be spoiled while he's waiting for gas and oil. But he says she'll boom someday, and if he do, they're gone away. Not called Pacific, not called Pacific. Pretty got no welfare and baby bonus guarantee. Someday he says we're going to get you, I say. As soon as we gets the gas and oil, we all goes to work for a little while. And then when the 20 weeks is in, we draws UIC again, guarantee. Guarantee. You never sees Freddy now, not the mampar, I suppose. Freddy's never had that mampar, I suppose. He said you could go down there, but you may as well wait up here. Cause when gas and oil comes in, sure they'll be up here looking for him, I suppose. I suppose. So I'm going away here on the front porch with Freddy. And when the gas and oil comes in, sure I'll be ready. Don't want no boom, anyhow, we've been without one up until now. I don't want me children spoiled with the waste of gas and oil. So how's your boat? Copacetic! Mine now! There's a pulse on my nerves, you got me drunk.
Now, Kevin is noted for singing, writing songs, but he's also noted for working with found objects.
I was going to play another song, old man. Didn't have that in mind at all.
We'll be right back.
Boys are boys. If you like, you can leave some garbage bags around. I can't know what I'm doing.
Good sample of bag music, that is.
We were talking about Becky earlier, and Wayne got a nice song about Becky.
Yes, the Becky song. Here it is. A few years ago when the times were rough, worked like the devil and you had to be tough. Worked in the garden and you worked in the woods and you worked on the windy waves. Poor Sam Jover worked for 2 long years, chopping down logs, he was strong as a bear. When he got his money and he paid his bill, 14 cents in the hole, said, "Don't mind the missus with a hole in her shoes. Don't mind the coal when my fingers turn blue. Don't mind the pantry with his gnar bit to grub, but it's hellish when you got no bay." The merchant with a grin on his face, chuckle in his eye and his heart start to race. Mustered up his courage and he stoked up his pipe, told him just where to stick it, said, "Don't mind the missus with a hole in the shoes. Don't mind the coal when my fingers turn blue. Don't mind the pantry when there's nar bit of grub, but it's hellish when you got no bay." Had 13 kids, only John and Harry, they were born in the bed. All of the others got dropped on the way from the kitchen out to the clothesline. Don't mind the missus with a hole in the shoes. Don't mind the coal when my fingers turn blue. Don't mind the pantry when there's nar bit to grub, but it's hellish when you got no bay. So don't you try to tell me you got hard, hard times. Dollar ain't a dollar and a dime ain't a dime. Paying out a fortune just to lose 10 pounds and you're eating 5 meals a day, said. Don't mind the missus with a hole in the shoes. Don't mind the coal when my fingers turn blue. Don't mind the pantry when there's not a bit to grow, but it's hellish when you got no bay. This guy is generously and generally, both of them, funny, but he's quite capable of writing a serious song, which he's done. He wrote a song called "Me Old Wooden Shack." Ray's gonna sing it.
See if I can get the technique down here.
Empty wishes leave a wanting man's soul.
takes away down that well-beaten path. And as memories come back from 80 years or more, I'm going to die in my old wooden shack. Got a horse when I was 30 years old, and a horse limb for 30 years more. When that lovely thing died, I hid and I cried. Where it is buried now grow a rose, with the wood we hauled on those hills, and training for cash and we bought all our needs and the animal feeds, and his wood left standing there still. Oh, the light from that old oil lamp lights a way down that well-beaten path, and as memories come back 80 years or more, I'm going to die in my old wooden shack.
About you, brother, but if you go, so I go too.
Oh, you're reaching for rock and roll, aren't you?
I rock can and tell. Roll, buddy. Huh? Rock and roll. That's starting to come right to pieces. Oh, man. I got to have it. I got to have it. I got to have it. Rock and roll! No!
Kevin. Why are you screwing up your face like that?
Bad, Raymond, old man, you haven't been in rock and roll, have you? My son, I can remember when I was a young fella, Raymond.
Yeah.
We'd have all our speakers behind it, rock and roll, see, old man? 50 big speakers like that, all shoved into a big cabinet that they poke right behind your ears, see?
Yes, yes.
Now, old man, see? You had every knob on the top of the amplificators up there. You had them all turned up on pressure cooks, see? And then you had the electric guitar with every knob on her, screwed reading tight so they couldn't come out, see? And oh man, Lord, you playing one on that driver down on that, and all the speakers pop out of the cabinet and would force the brain to the front of the skull and you'd have to squint, see?
Oh, boy.
I seen it before in a place just like this. And far exits was there and up there, old man, and large arms every time you drive out on our speakers and pop out, drive everybody out through the doors and you haul back on her. Everybody be drawn right back in again. And it was out and out and in the whole works. Rock and roll!
Well, I really understand that now. But why do you close your eyes?
Because I got the words written on the inside of the eyelids.
Well, let's do something for him, Kevin.
Let's go.
All right, man! She got no shoes. You can smell her coming when she's way up the street. She ain't took no bath, got to be them feet. I don't know her postal code, I never wrote it down. But she lives on the other side of town, and she's neat. A polka breaker. That's the best polka you're gonna hear anywhere.
Kevin, they seem to enjoy you.
Yeah.
We do have a special guest for you now, ladies and gentlemen. Wayne, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've heard of Bruce Springsteen, Huey Lewis, Mick Jagger, and characters of that nature. Well, for those of you who feel they're rock stars, forget it. What you are about to see will diminish their image quite substantially. Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from North Shore, Glovertown, coming to you in living candy colored. Here he is, Elvis Sleasley. Woo!
What are you gonna do for us, sir?
I'm gonna do an old song called Hound the Dog. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. Oh, you lifted your leg and you peed on top of mine.
Now, I understand now, sir, you go around imitating people. But I heard you had some difficulty every time you went into the men's washroom.
Well, it's like just being an Elvis entertainer and an Elvis impressionist and all that. You know, I often go into a washroom only to have people turn to me and say, "Oh, look, it's Elvis."
I see.
Hell of a way to get a shower after a gig.
Yeah, sure. And a couple of months ago, I heard poor Elvis had his nose removed before he passed on. He never,
no.
What?
No,
plastic
actually,
surgery,
it,
I heard it was.
No, well, it wasn't removed as such.
No.
Surgically, no.
No.
Explained.
It was drugs.
Drugs?
Yeah, he was sniffing a lot of cocaine there at the end, and
what
happened is when you sniff cocaine,
yes.
When it happens, is it, your nose gets rubbery. And he got onto a lot of it there one night, and he got really soft in the middle of the head there, and well, he was.
Wicked, old man, wicked.
What are you? He sucked his nose back down his throat. He choked on it and died.
Poor fella.
That's how he died. Now, I would like to sing a song, and this one is a tribute to Elvis's last number. And if he were still here, he'd sing it like this. Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
Everett Sleasley.
Ladies and gentlemen, many of you people do not realize we have come many miles here to be here tonight to be with you people. Isn't that beautiful? I look about upon you people tonight, and I see a lot of people who have come here wondering if salvation can be purchased. You leave Jimmy out of this. It was my wife he was fooling around with. You cannot buy salvation. And I say, incorrect! I happen to have salvation right with me tonight. In the form of a buddy, what's his name, and the other fellow's record. Now, some people say, well, why is that salvation? I mean, in this. I say, well, we're family men. Wayne is a family man. He has two boys waiting for him back at home. And a beautiful wife waiting to see his face come in the door once again. And Raymond is a family man. He's got a little boy and his wife is going to deliver him a new son come May. Isn't that beautiful? I don't know. We'll see when it comes.
That wasn't supposed to be in that, Kevin.
I'm a family man as well, Raymond. I have a wife and two beautiful little girls. One of them's only just this big. One of them is still taking the Pampers and Vaseline. It's my wife. She's... She's like that.
Well, that's not what I come here to talk about, ladies and gentlemen. Let me tell you right from my heart. Number one got after me last week, and he said,
Kevin, unless you come up with $8 million by tax time,
you're going to be punching civil service forever in the east wing of the Confederation building. Now, number one, I don't know about you, is number one here tonight?
And we all know Brian is a good guy. But when he tries to make the sunshine capital of the world out of Mount Pearl, you know there's something missing.
Heck, what are we going to do with all them cucumbers? Try to make vegetarians out of the seals?
killed two Brahmins in one time. It's a good effort, but you try and grow a cucumber in Mount Pearl, I just don't believe it myself. Ladies and gentlemen, nevertheless, he is number one, and he said to me, if I don't collect the $8 million, I'm in doing civil service. I don't know about you, but I'm not a simple servant. I'm not a simple servant. I was never cut out to be. King of the carnival, maybe. However, number one said, we're going to take all that money. I'm going to start a road. It's going to be a four-lane highway. I'm going to reach the railway forever. It's going to go right across the province. Right from St. John's, straight on across.
To Foxtrot.
It may be Foxtrot, but nevertheless, number one said, so we happened to come here with an offer. We didn't come here begging! We want a fair exchange! I'll sell you salvation.
Why is this salvation? Why? Because you'll be saving earnings if you buy one.
And it's equivalent in a cassette tape, just the same.
Some people say, you're just trying to sell off records and tapes.
I'm not just trying to sell you records and tapes. I happen to have t-shirts as well. Gotta get my Moose Boy t-shirts. A little piece of advice on the back there. Leave chummy attached. Bilby, we were trying to peddle our wares through a little hole in the wall over here during break time, so...
But, Kevin, you're not finished. That's tapes, records, and t-shirts, but there's something else, the most important.
Oh, yes, we're after getting in the caps lately. In order to become a member of the fraternity, we got this cap here like that, see? They ripped us off. They only sold us half of them cap. Anyway, Buddy, what's his name, and the other fellas printed up here. And of course, they're only $5 each. $4.98. $4.50. Do I hear $3?
Well, Kevin, we should
freak you. Okay, we have to.
We'll take a 15-20 minute break.
We have to take a little break, and we're going to be back. This is a song you can sing along with. This one, okay? This one is called Uncle Lowe's Breakdown. Sing, you idiots!